The topic that we are going to cover today is how to estimate the effect sizes. Now, you may be thinking that what is this effect size? Okay. If you see this picture, and this picture is a very common picture in all the papers of meta-analysis. So we will discuss on this picture today. This picture is known as forest plot. Forest plot. Now, in the forest plot, if you see, we are having the different columns. The first column is the study name. And the second, in second column, you can see some boxes with some lines. Actually, some of the boxes are very big boxes, and some of the boxes are very small boxes. The big boxes means the weight of these boxes are high. And there are some small boxes, it means the weight of these boxes are small. Right, weight. And if I ask you, on what basis these boxes may come? Right. So there is a simple logic in all the research papers that if your sample size is high, the probability that your values are closer to the actual value is also high. Means the accuracy of the result is also high. And if you are conducting a study on very small sample, so can you say your studies are very accurate? May not be. So we assign the weights to different studies. Some studies we provide high weights, and some studies we provide the low weights. And one of the basic reason of the weight is the sample size. So large sample size, more weight. Less sample size, less weight. And you can see that the this is suppose this part. I hope you can see the cursor. Yeah. So this study, these studies are having big body, but variance is less because of the large sample size. And if you see this case, we can see the body is very small and the variance is high, right? Then we are having these values is actually the expected true value from that study. This is the expected value, true value from that study. Now this value may be the difference, this value may be the risk ratio, this value may be the correlation, this value may be the odd ratio. So that we are going to discuss in this lecture. And after that, we are having the weight. How much weight we assign? So more weight, big body. Less weight, less body. Right. So this kind of plot we are going to make today, and we will understand each and everything in this plot. So let's move. Okay. Now the basic problem in research papers is that if your p-value is coming to be less than 0.05, you are very happy. Like this person is very happy. And because why he is happy? Because the result is found to be significant, right? And today morning I was discussing with one scholar, and when I do the analysis, all the p values are found to be more than 0.05. So you cannot believe that the scholar feel depressed that my study is useless, my probability value is more than 0.05. It means all null hypothesis I have to accept or fail to reject, and there is no significant conclusion I can draw from my study. So most of the researchers focus on p-value, right? So all the pictures here, they are representing the importance of p-value. If I explain in nominal, in layman language, that what is the p-value? So p-value is the probability that is due to the chance, right? So p-value stands from probability value. It indicates how likely it is that a result occurred by chance alone. So if the percentage is very low, like 0.1%, 0.01%, 0.01%, then we can say the study is significant. So the rule of thumb that we adopted in most of the research studies, assuming the 95% confidence level, that if probability value is less than 0.05, then we can say null hypothesis can be rejected. And the moment we say null hypothesis can be rejected, it means we are very happy. But the problem is that here in meta-analysis, we are not focusing on the p-value. In meta-analysis, actually, we want to find out the true value of the result. True value of the result. Result may be the odd ratio, risk ratio, difference, mean difference, or the correlation. Like I'm telling you a simple case. I want to start with this story. So it is actually a story that one of my relative recognized with the fourth stage of cancer. And the query which comes in all of us mind that how long the patient can survive now. So this is the research question that we have at the time, that how long the patient can survive. Now some doctors say that, like doctor who is working with a Max hospital, he say that the patient cannot survive more than 6 months. The doctor of Fortis hospital say that the patient can survive even up to 6 years. Then some cancer hospital say that the patient can survive maximum 2 years. Now the problem is that if I check the p value, all are found to be significant, right? So suppose, right, if I check the p value from different papers, the p value is found to be significant, it means everybody is saying significantly. But my answer is not coming, right? I'm not getting my answer. My answer is simply that how long that person will survive. Now the question is that some studies say 6 months, some studies say 6 years, some studies say 2 years. Now, I'm not getting my answer. The problem is that what is the real answer? So meta-analysis is the only analysis which can give me the right answer. So meta-analysis will give you the right answer that on an average, how long the person can survive. So in meta-analysis, we are not focusing on the p-value because all may be significant. But the problem is that p-value is not giving the answer of my research question. Like for example, I'm giving you another example. Now, suppose I want to know how the debt equity ratio have an impact on the market capitalization of the company. Right, market capitalization is nothing, it is a measure of the wealth creation, whether the value of the share of the company will increase or not. Or you can assume that what is the impact of attitude on the purchase intention. So suppose let's assume with this example, I want to know what is the relationship between attitude of a consumer on the between purchase intention. Now some papers say the correlation is 0.3 significant. Some papers say correlation is 0.9 significant. Some papers say correlation is 0.6 significant. Right, actually, the p-value is not getting my answers, not giving the answer of my research question. I want to know what is the exact correlation between the attitude and the purchase intention. So I want the magnitude of the correlation. Right, I do not want to focus on the p-value. I want the actual correlation between the two. So who will give me the answer? Meta-analysis. The meta-analysis will give you the answer. Actually, what is the true value of the relationship? So you can imagine, right? You can imagine how important is this. Now, recently I had a discussion with one of the person is a person in a hospital in there is a lab, IPCA lab, something like that. So he say that there are different studies are going on the corona vaccine. In some cases, the risk ratio is 10%. In some trials, the risk ratio is 20%, right? In India, the risk ratio is 40%. So actually confused, right? What is the actual importance, actual effectiveness of this vaccine? So meta-analysis gives you the solution that what is the actual effectiveness of this vaccine? So meta-analysis will give you the answer of all these type of questions. So one attitude which we have to change in meta-analysis that we have to move from p-value to the magnitude, and that true magnitude is known as effect size. So I hope slowly you will understand this. Now if we compare the effect size with p-value, the p-value is telling you whether the relationship is significant or not. So here we are talking about in context of the correlation or the difference between the two groups. The p-value will only tell you that whether the relationship is significant or whether the difference between two groups is significant or not. But effect size will tell you that what is the true difference between the two groups. Effect size will tell you what is the actual correlation between the two groups. So this is the difference between p-value and the effect size. effect size cannot be used quantitatively compare the result of the studies in a different setting. For example, if magnitude of one study is 0.05 and a second p-value is 0.03, you can only say that the p-value is more significant in 0.03 or 0.05, right? If the value is significant near to 0.05, we cannot compare the correlation, right? So in when we compare the p-value, so we cannot compare the magnitude. This is the problem actually. The focus is only the comparison of the probability value. So significance, statistical significance tells only the likelihood that is observed result are due to the chance alone. How likely it is due to the chance. It is showing only the statistical significance. It is not telling you the true value. However, effect size will tell you the magnitude of the test. If it is a correlation test, the effect size will tell you the what is the actual correlation between the two, right? And so we can compare the magnitude. We can find out where the correlation is high or the mean difference is high, where it is low. So effect size is actually giving you the true value. So if you want to write, if you want to understand effect size in one sentence, effect size will give you the true value or true population value that can be calculated from that study. So if you have 10 studies, you have to calculate 10 effect sizes, 10 effect size, right? So 10 true values we have to calculate. And when you calculate the true effect size, from that we can find out the population value. Population value can be calculated from the all effect sizes. Okay, so this is just an example. I already explained with the help of many examples. Like once more, suppose we want to know the effect of a therapy on treating depression. And depression, you know how important it is nowadays. The effect size, p-value here will only tell us whether it is significant or not. But the effect size will tell you that what is the actual effect of this therapy on the effect size. The effect size value will show us if the therapy had a small, medium or large effect on the depression. So it will tell us the magnitude of the independent variable on the outcome variable. Okay, we will see. Now, very important. We have three families for effect size. Or in general, we can say that there are three type of papers. There are three type of papers in meta-analysis. One, which is based on standardized mean difference. Second, which is based on risk ratio, odds ratio. And third, which is based on correlation. So because I'm going to discuss it in very detail, so here I'm just telling you the brief. That there are three cases. There are three cases mainly where we are applying the meta-analysis. So I'm going to explain each case in much detail. Okay. So we called these three cases as family. Like there are two pictures I posted in this slide. And both I take from the book. Like type of effect size, most of you use D family, R family, or ratio family. Right. So majorly there are three families of calculating the effect size. First family is known as D family. Second family is called R family. And third family is known as odd ratio family. And in one of the book, they mentioned that the effect size is categorized into two groups, D family and the R family, and they put odd ratio or risk ratio in the D family. So there are three families in total on which we calculate the effect size. Number one, R family, which is based on the correlation. D family, which is based on the difference of the mean of the two groups. And third family, where I put the risk ratio and the odd ratio. Right. So these are the common terms, D family, R family. So whenever we talk about the meta-analysis, so D family and R family comes very frequently. So we should know that on which family we are working. D family means difference between the mean of two groups. R family means correlation between the two variables. And odd ratio and risk ratio, we normally talk in the medical science, where we want to see the effect of the experiment on the improvement, effect on the medicine, on the improvement, like this. And in marketing also, we conducted many research, many experiments. In these experiments, we also calculate the risk ratio and odd ratio. The risk ratio and odd ratio are also important in experimental design. So we are going to discuss on that. Now I'm going to go in detail. Because up to now, I just tell you in brief that what is the family we are working with, and what is the effect size, how it is different from the probability value. Now we are going to the technical details. So listen, the first family is D family. I'm going to consider the D family first. So what is D family? You can assume that there are two groups. One is control group and second is experimental group. And we want to compare the effect of some experiment on the two groups. So group one and group two. So we are having two groups. So we need three data set for each group. For what is the mean of the group? And what is the sample size of the group? And what is the standard deviation of this group? Right. We call them samples also. We call them groups also. Because in experimental designs, normally we divide the groups into control group and the experimental group. Experimental group is that group where you are doing the experiment, and that control group is that group which is used to just compare. So assume that group one is a control group, and we are having the x1 bar mean of the group. Suppose mean means, suppose we calculate the temperature, suppose we calculate the improvement, suppose we calculate the performance of this, right? So it depends upon the research question actually what we compare. So x1 is the continuous variable, n1 is the sample size of first group, s1 is the standard deviation of the first group. Similarly, we have this data also for the second group. So when you want to work, when you want to write the research paper on the meta-analysis on D family, you have to find out those papers where these values are given. And in medical science, you cannot imagine that how common it is, because they find out the effect of the vaccine on the patient. So they divide the patient into two groups. One group, they provide the vaccine and find out the temperature maybe, and then they compare. Now, step number one in D family is to calculate the data set. And these data set you will calculate only from the different published research papers. Now, second step is that you have to calculate the pooled standard deviation. The second step is to find out the pooled standard deviation of all the studies. So the formula is given here. And after calculating the standard deviation, pooled standard deviation, we have to calculate the Cohen's D. Cohen's D, you can see here, it is nothing, it is the difference between the mean divided by standard error. So pooled standard deviation. This Cohen D is telling you the average difference between the mean of two groups. But the problem is that a research problem, there is another professor, the name of the professor is Hedger. So he say that the Cohen's D is a biased value. So it gives you positive bias, means it gives you more than expected difference, right? Some more difference, positive bias, right? So Hedger's claims that the Cohen's D, which is calculating the difference between the two means divided by the standard deviation, right? Pooled standard deviation is a biased figure. So I'm showing you one of the paragraphs that I take from one book. And this book, this say that if you just read the paragraph, it turns out that D has a slight bias, tending to overestimate the absolute value of delta in small samples. This bias can be removed by a simple correction that yields an unbiased estimate of delta. So this correction is denoted by J. So Hedger's G is the true unbiased value of the difference between the two groups. So what we do, we calculate the correction by J. This is the correction, right? Correction factor. So we calculate this correction factor, which is based on the degree of freedom, 1 minus 3 upon 4 df minus 1. And after that, we calculate the value of G, right? G. So G is equal to J correction factor multiplied by Cohen's D. So this G, when we calculate this G, this is the effect size of that study. And from there, we have to calculate the variance also. Variance means if the sample size is low, variance is high. If the sample size is high, the variance is low. So on the basis of the variance, we have to calculate the weight. If in any study, the variance is very high, we have to provide less weight. Right? So think on this sentence. I'm saying that if the variance in a study is very high, we have to provide less weight. And if the variance in a study is less, then we have to provide more weight. So we have to calculate the weight. How we calculate the weight? Weight is equal to 1 upon variance. So in this case, the variance is calculated by J square. It is the square of the J multiplied by the variance of D. And this is the formula of the diamond from all of this. Now, I am just practically showing you how to calculate all these values from Jamovi, as well as I want to show you the calculation part so that the clarity will be more. So before going to the case number two, I want to show you the case number one, how we can calculate that. Then we will move to the case number two. Now the data which I am going to use is, I already shared that this is the data one, case number one. And if you see in the data set, we are having the study. This is the author of the study. And N1 is the sample size of group number one. N2 is the sample size of group number two. M1 is the mean of sample one. M2 is the mean of sample two. SD1 is the standard deviation of sample one. SD2 is the standard deviation of sample two. So why this data is important for you? Because if you are going to write a paper on the standardized mean difference of when somebody conducted the experiment and compare control group and experimental group, what kind of data you must have? So this is the minimum information you must have if you write a paper on the meta-analysis based on the difference. So now, how to calculate the effect size? So first of all, I'm showing you the calculation part, which I already done in one of the Excel file. Okay. So now I take this the values. And this is the case number two. Okay, I opened the wrong file. Case number one. Yeah. Yes. Now in this file, I hope you can see the file. The data which I have is this. Just see carefully. So we are having the sample size of the group number one, sample size of the group number two, mean of group number one, mean of group number two, standard deviation of the group number one, standard deviation of the group number two. So as I told you, the first step, we have to find out the pooled standard deviation. So it is called pooled standard deviation. And formula is, or pooled standard deviation is this. So I applied this formula and calculate the pooled standard deviation. These are the values. So these are the values of pooled standard deviation. So from the pooled standard deviation, I calculate the Cohen's D. So Cohen's D, what is Cohen's D? This is the mean of first group minus mean of second group. And I can show you that if you just see carefully, mean of group number one minus mean of group number two and divided by this pooled difference. So divided by the pooled standard deviation. So this is the value. If I just click it and reduce the decimal point to two, these are my Cohen's D value. Right, then from the Cohen's D value, I find out the variance. So variance is written here. The formula of variance is written here. N1 plus N2 upon N1 into N2. N1 is the sample size of the group number one. And what is N2? The sample size of group number two. D value, Cohen's D. So I calculated the value of the variance. So this is the value of the variance. And after D and VD, then because we know that this Cohen's D is a biased figure. So Cohen's D is suffering from the over bias, positive bias. So we have to find out the correction factor. So this correction factor, the formula is written here. And the J is equal to 1 minus 3, 4 upon degree of freedom minus 1. Degree of freedom here is N1 plus N2 minus 2. So here the degree of freedom is N1 plus N2 minus 2. This is the correction factor. And if I multiply this correction factor with the D, you can see that all the correction factor is less than 1, right? If we multiply D with the 1, we will get 73, but all the correction factors, you can see they are slightly less than 1. So if we multiply this correction factor with the Cohen's D, I will get the Hedger's G. So Hedger's G is nothing. It is the multiplication of the correction factor and the Cohen's d, and after that I calculated the Helger's g. Then I calculated the Vg. Vg means the variance of the Helger's g. The formula is written here: j square into Vd. So this is j square into Vd. This is the variance, and from the variance I calculated the weight. Now what is weight? Weight is nothing. It is 1 upon Vg. Weight is 1 upon Vg, right? So this is the weight. I calculated the weight. I calculated the g. So whenever you see the software will give you these values directly, right? So I will share this file so that you can understand the calculation. Now I am showing you how to do this calculation in Jamovi, and we will compare that are we getting the exactly these values or not. So these are the effect sizes. This is the values which you can see in the yellow is the effect size. What is the effect size? The true possible value of the difference between the two mean. So this difference is known as a standardized mean difference. So Helger's g is the effect size, and from this effect size, right, if I want to calculate the overall value from all values, so this value is called diamond, right? So although I will focus on the diamond tomorrow, but if you want to get the one single value from all the studies, this is called diamond. So as I told you in my example, that somebody say that the patient will survive for 6 months, somebody say the patient will survive for the two years, and somebody say the patient will survive for 6 years. This diamond will tell me that your patient will survive maximum 3 years. Your patient will survive on an average 3 years. So I got the answer. So it means if the patient will take some precautions, the patient can survive for 3 years. So this is my answer. This answer is called diamond, right? This answer is known as diamond. So let me show you the calculation in Jamovi. Actually, if you understand all the calculation, then you can go up to the higher statistics. Otherwise, you cannot go beyond a level. So that's why I'm showing you all the calculation. Now let me show the Jamovi software, how to do all these things in Jamovi. Now I'm going to open the Jamovi software. So when you open the Jamovi, you will get this kind of icon, and if you click it, you will have the software ready to work for you. Now this is the front page of the software. So first thing that you need to do is click on the plus. You can see a plus here. If you click on the plus, and you can go for the Jamovi library, and if you go to the Jamovi library, you need to find out the major. So you can see that these are the different options we are having, and the option which we are going to use for this workshop is major. So just click on this, because I already installed this, but first time you have to install the major to work for data, for meta analysis. So I already installed. Like for example, I just show you that if I want to do some analysis, let's say linear models, advanced mediation model. Okay, suppose I want to use this jam. So I click on the install, and the software will install this. Similarly, you have to install what? Major. So after the installation, you can find out the options here. So we are having the different options, different modules, and we are going to work on the major. Now how to do? So first of all, you know that we need file. So go to click on this, open the file, and we have to find out our file. We are having the file case number one. And after this, you can see the file here. And one thing which you need to check is that all the variables which should be scaled. The variables which should be ordinal, and nominal. So we are having two problems here. This sample size and sample two is assumed to be nominal by the software. Actually, they are not nominal. So we have to double click on it. And when you click on the double click, you have to change it to continuous variable. Similarly, I will click on this also, continuous variable. So you have to define all the variables continuous, then click. Okay, now I have all the variables continuous variable, which is the most important requirement to apply meta analysis. Now I am going to apply the major software for my meta analysis. Okay, so I have to check whether all my variables are is continuous variables or not. Yes, now I have all the variables continuous. Now click on the major. So I want to work on mean difference. So this is the D family. So where I require sample size, mean and standard deviation. So I want to work on this mean difference, and let's click on the mean difference. So when you click on the mean difference, you will have these options, right? Now software is asking you what? So tell me the group one sample size. So this is N1. Now group one mean, this is M1. Software is asking for group one standard deviation. Yeah, I have this standard deviation one. Then software is asking you group two sample size, that is N2. Group two mean, that is M2. And group two standard deviation, that is SD2. And the studies, yeah, I have the studies also. So now you can see that after just clicking this, you are having your answers here. So you, right. So you can see this is my answer. The diamond value is 0.52. This is the diamond which actually we want. And this is one of the output you need to publish in your paper. And let me compare these values with my results. let's take this value and go back to the file. Yeah, no, this is not the file. Yes, so if I click here, so you can see that the values are similar. 7373, 7474, -41, -41, 2.01, 2.01. So my values are exactly the same values as provided by the software, right? And these are the plus standard error of the value. And so this is my Jamovi result. And this is my calculation of the effect size. And this is the diamond value. So I think now you feel happy that how we calculated the complicated things in Jamovi very easily.